Welcome dear student and Jai Swaminarayan. In the previous video we were discuss about rules for making a ray diagram by a convex lens and the image formation by a convex lens for the various position of the object, right? Now dear student, in this video we will understand about the rules for making a ray diagram by a concave lens and the image formation by a concave lens for the various position of the object. So dear student, up till now you were not seen the previous video. First see the previous video for the image formation by a convex lens and then see this video so you can understand better in this video, right? So let us start with the concave lens. What do you mean by the concave lens? When the both the curved surface of the lens is a inward direction, right? The lens is said to be a concave lens. So in the spherical lens, if the both the curved surface are curved inward direction, right, the lens is called the concave lens. And how the image formed by the concave lens, what type of the image formed by the concave lens, we will see in this video. So dear student, first of all let us start with the rules for making a ray diagram by a concave lens. So rules for image formation by a concave lens, right? We use these rules to form the image, to draw a ray diagram by a concave lens. So first rules for making a ray diagram by concave lens is a ray parallel to the principal axis appear to diverge from the principal focus located on the same size of the lens. So dear student, when the rays of the light parallel to the principal axis, after refraction it will appear to diverge from the principal focus which is located on the same side of the lens. So if we considering this ray of the light which is parallel to the principal axis, this ray of the light after refraction by a concave lens, it will divert it such that it will appear to pass from the principal focus on the same side of the object. So dear student, first rule state that when the rays of the light parallel to the principal axis, after refraction it will appear to diverge from the principal focus on the same side of the lens. Understand dear student, when the ray of the light passing parallel to the principal axis, it will divert it such that it will appear from the principal focus, first principal focus. Now what is the second rule? Second rule is exactly inverse of the first rule. When the ray of the light appearing to meet at the principal focus of a concave lens will emerge parallel to the principal axis, right? So if we considering a ray of light incident on the concave lens such that it will appear to pass from the principal focus, second principal focus, but due to the material of the lens the ray of the light is diverted, and such that when the ray of the light is diverted such that it is parallel to the principal axis. So dear student, second rule states that when the ray of the light incident on the concave lens will appearing to meet from the at the principal focus, it will appearing to meet from the principal focus, right, after refraction it will be parallel to the principal axis. So emerging ray of the light is parallel to the principal axis. So dear student, when the ray of the light incident on the concave lens such that it will appear to pass from the second principal focus, after refraction the ray of the light is parallel to the principal axis, right? Understand? Now, third rule for the image formation by a concave lens is, when a ray of the light passing through the optical center of the lens will emerge without any deviation. This rule is similar to the convex lens, right? So when the ray of the light is passing through the optical center of the concave lens, it will not divert it. The emergent ray is without deviation. It will going in the same direction. So dear student, understand all the three rules for making a ray diagram by a concave lens, right? So let us revise once again all the three rules, right? Rule number one, when the ray of the light is parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, it will diverge such that it will appear to pass from the principal focus. So this ray of the light parallel to the principal axis diverges such that if we extend this ray beyond, it will appear to pass from the principal focus. Now what is the second rule? So when the ray of the light incident on the concave lens, right, such that it will appearing to meet or appearing to pass from the second principal focus, after refraction, the ray of the light is emergent parallel to the principal axis, right? Now, rule number three. What is the rule number three? When the ray of the light passing through the optical center, right? Optical center of the lens, right? After refraction, the refracted ray will emerge without any deviation. That means the ray of the light is going in the same direction as we incident on the lens. So now dear student, with the help of the rules for making a ray diagram by a concave lens, we understand how the image formed by the concave lens. So let us understand the ray diagram of the image formed by the concave lens. We use the minimum of the two rules which we were discuss earlier, right? Out of these three rules, we use the two rules to form a image by a concave lens for the various position of the object. So let us discuss, student, how the image formed by the concave lens for the different position of the object with the help of the ray diagram. So the ray diagram of the image formed by the concave lens for the various position of the object. So firstly, if we consider that, first, when the object is at the infinite distance, right? So we consider the, what is the infinite distance? So when the object is very far from the concave lens, right? So when the an object is placed at the infinite distance, so rays coming from the infinite distance, rays emerging from the infinite distance are incident on the concave lens which are parallel to the principal axis. So here we consider, when the object is at the infinite distance, right, the rays coming from the infinite distance are parallel to the principal axis. Now when the rays of the light are incident parallel to the principal axis, it will divert it such that it will appear to meet at a principal focus. So if we considering this ray of the light parallel to the principal axis are diverted such that it will appear to meet at the principal focus of the mirror, principal focus of the lens on the same side. And another ray, if we consider this ray parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, it will divert it such that it will appear to meet at the principal focus. So at the principal focus, we get the image of the object, and which is on the same side as the object will were placed, right? So When the object is placed at the infinite distance, the image will be formed at the principal focus, first principal focus. So the position of the image is at the first principal focus, right? F1, not F2, it will be a F1, right? So the image will be formed on the same side as the object will place, right? So the position of the image is at the principal focus F1. Now, what type of the image will be produced by a concave lens? So here, these two ray, after refraction, these two ray does not meet at a point, right? But if we extend beyond this ray, these two rays are appear to meet at the principal focus. So the type of the image produced by a concave lens is a virtual and the erect. So here the image will be produced at the principal focus. The nature of the image is a virtual and erect, and the size of the image is a very small, that is a point size, or we can say that the highly diminished, right? So when the object placed at the infinite distance from the concave lens, its image will be produced at the principal focus on the same side as the object, right? The nature of the image is virtual and erect, and the size of the image is very small, like a point size, or we can say that the highly diminished. So now, second case, when the object is placed between infinity distance and the optical center, when the object is placed at any distance between the infinity distance and the optical center, where the image will be produced. So for that, if we consider the object AB is placed between the infinity distance and the optical center, anywhere on the principal axis. So consider this object, right? Object AB is placed at this position, right? Now to form the image by a concave lens, we need to consider a minimum of a two rays. So first ray, if we consider ray parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, it will appear to pass from the second principal focus, first principal focus, right? So, and second ray, if we consider the second ray, when the ray of the light is passing from the optical center, right, it will emerge without any deviation. So, if we extend this ray beyond, it will in the same direction. So, when these two rays are meet at this point, the image of a point A produced at this point A dash. So, here the image will be produced at the A dash B dash between the principal focus and the optical center. So, dear student, when the object is placed at any distance between the infinity and the optical center, the image will be produced between the principal focus and the optical center on the same side of the object. The nature of the image is a virtual and erect, because we are extending this ray in the backward direction and we get a image, right? So the image will be produced virtual and the erect, right? So when the object is placed between the any distance, infinity and optical center, the image will be produced virtual and the erect image produced by a concave lens, right? And the size of the image is diminished, that means the smaller than the object. So dear student, with the help of the concave lens, the image will be produced always virtual and erect, and the size of the image is smaller than the object. So understand, dear student, how the image formed by the concave lens, both the case, right? When the object is at the infinity distance, the image will be produced at the first principal focus, and when the object is placed at any distance between the infinity एंड द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर द इमेज विल बी प्रोड्यूस बिटवीन द फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल फोकस एंड द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर एंड द नेचर ऑफ द इमेज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द कॉन्केव लेंस इज ऑलवेज वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट एंड द साइज ऑफ द इमेज इज डिमिनिश दैट मीन्स अ वेरी स्मॉल. नाउ लेट अस समराइज बोथ द केस विद द हेल्प ऑफ द टेबल. सो फर्स्ट द इमेज फॉर्म बाय द नेचर पोजिशन एंड द साइज ऑफ द इमेज फॉर्म बाय द कॉन्केव लेंस फॉर द वेरियस पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. सो फर्स्ट केस इज अ वेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस एट द इन्फाइनाइट डिस्टेंस द पोजिशन ऑफ द इमेज विल बी फॉर्म एट द प्रिंसिपल फोकस एफ वन. साइज ऑफ द इमेज इज हाईली डिमिनिश दैट मीन्स द वेरी स्मॉल लाइक अ पॉइंट साइज एंड द नेचर ऑफ द इमेज इज अ वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट. नाउ सेकेंड केस इज वेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस एट एनी डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द इन्फिनिटिव एंड द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर ऑफ द लेंस द इमेज विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड बिटवीन प्रिंसिपल फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल फोकस एफ वन एंड द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर ओ. सो हियर द इमेज विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड बिटवीन द फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल फोकस एंड द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. द साइज ऑफ द इमेज इज डिमिनिश दैट मीन्स द स्मॉलर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड द नेचर ऑफ द इमेज इज वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट. सो डियर स्टूडेंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द कॉन्केव लेंस द इमेज फॉर्म बाय द कॉन्केव लेंस इज ऑलवेज वर्चुअल एंड इरेक्ट. अंडरस्टैंड डियर स्टूडेंट. सो डियर स्टूडेंट आई होप दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द इमेज फॉर्म बाय द कॉन्केव लेंस फॉर द वेरियस पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. Thank you.